February is Black History Month. It's also Heart Health Month. It's giving us an opportunity to recognize some really incredible Nashville residents who've been game changers in the health industry while also addressing racial disparities still existing in our community today. News 4's Chris Miller reports.
Vivian, Dr. Blaylock wanted you to have this.
Excuse me, all workers punch in at the rear entrance.
He's with me.
Oh, I'm sorry, Dr. Blaylock, but that's the rules.
The movie, Something the Lord Made, depicts the real-life story of Vivian Thomas, a man who overcame poverty and racial inequality to become a critical figure that pioneered modern heart surgery.
So we have a lot of people that everybody needs to be aware of.
There's Dr. Levi Watkins, the first surgeon to successfully implant an automatic defibrillator in a human being. These are just two African Americans with Nashville ties who made critical contributions that revolutionized the heart health industry.
Meanwhile, heart disease and stroke remain the number one killer in America, even more common if you're black.
You're less likely to be brought to the emergency room to have emergent care. And the time to get there to you is much longer than if it occurred in the white population.
Dr. Andre Churchwell is a cardiologist and the chief diversity officer at Vanderbilt.
We know about issues that are unique to the white population, and we have spent a lot of money in those areas, but there are clear health disparities that are affecting marginalized populations.
According to the American Heart Association, African Americans are more likely to have high blood pressure and diabetes and more likely to be obese. All contribute to heart disease.
We're staying at home with our heart disease and letting it get to a fairly severe end stage before we finally are brought by our family to the emergency room because we don't trust the medical system.
Dr. Churchwell says it's a problem that affects all of Nashville.
We cannot be successful in this country unless we deal with health disparities that are facing all groups.
The American Heart Association is working to bring health clinics into low-income areas and to improve messaging, hoping to build trust between the healthcare industry and the African-American community.
Health disparities have to be addressed on a moral basis, but if you really need to think of it as a business investment, think of it that way.
Dr. Churchwell says many people who suffer skip the doctor simply because they don't have the money, choosing to feed their family instead of treating their high blood pressure and heart disease. There's also the suggestion that there's limited access to healthy foods in low-income communities, a lack of safe parks to exercise, and the inability to afford transportation to access these things. I'm News 4 morning anchor Chris Miller.